ஹாய் எவ்ரிவன், இன்னைக்கு நம்ம பார்க்க போகிற டாபிக் என்ன அப்படின்னா, இட் இஸ் அபவுட் குட்ஸ். ஓகே, ஒரு பிஸ்னஸில் வந்து ஒரு இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டேர்ம் இஸ் கால்டு குட்ஸ். வாட் வி ஆர் பையிங் அண்ட் செல்லிங் மீன்ஸ் குட்ஸ் வி ஆர் பையிங் அண்ட் செல்லிங். ஓகே, பிஃபோர் என்டர் திஸ் டு திஸ் சாப்டர், ஐ மீன்ஸ் அபவுட் குட்ஸ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் அண்ட் ஆஸ் வெல் அஸ் வாட் ஆர் த டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் குட்ஸ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் நவ். Before entering to this, we shall discuss about the what is the contract of sale. Sale na enna appadina, the sale is nothing but transferring the ownership to one person to another person, from seller to buyer. Okay, if the trade transaction is for own purpose, personal purpose, means that is not come under the sale act. Only the money transaction, money to goods only will come under the sales contract of sale. Okay, let me discuss about the goods. What we are selling in the market means we are transferring the ownership to another person. What transaction means, it is a goods, it includes a goods. What and all will come under this goods, Abdina? This goods will include the all the movable properties. We can say it as a goods, like shares, stock, growing crops, okay. Then goodwill, trademark, copyrights, patent rights, okay. Like that, everything will come, all the movable properties will come under the goods. What is immovable, I mean, what and all won't come under the goods means, what and all is excluded from the goods means, it is nothing but an immovable property. This immovable property, like auctionable claims, money, and money, auctionable claim, and immovable property will exclude in this. What are the types of goods? What are the types of goods means? Basically, there are three types of goods. One is existing goods, another one is future goods, and the third one is contingent goods. Under this existing goods, first type is an existing goods. Under this existing goods, we can divide this existing goods as a three types. Okay. So one is ascertained goods, unascertained goods, and the specific goods, we can say. What is mean by this unascertained goods means? It is just imagine that you are entering into one showroom. We can see the goods, like for example, we are entering into the car showroom. There the car was displayed and the variety of cars are displayed and the prices also was displayed there. Okay, so just we are entering into the showroom, just seeing that products were displayed, that we can say it as an unascertained goods. After go throughing all the unascertained goods, we are just trying to select any one of the variety or the any type of car what we are liked. So we are selecting any one of the car. So that is an ascertaining. Now we are ascertaining a goods. Okay. Then this ascertainment is over. We won't select only one product. First try we'll select the two or three products, two or three variety of goods. Out of that, we'll select any one that we can say it as a specific goods. We can say that unascertained means it is just entering into a showroom. We are not selecting any of the goods. After selecting the two or three variety of cars, we can say that is an ascertained goods. At last, we are going to purchase any one specific goods, what we are like most. Okay, so that is a specific goods. So this we can call it as an existing goods, type number one. The next we go to, we can see about the future goods. Future goods means the sale agreement will be done by a person, that sale agreement contract is now, but we are going to receive that goods in the future. For example, if we are ordering catering services for a marriage function, the marriage is going to help after 3 months, but this month, if we are about to give an advance and if we are, we should have a sale agreement to that contract person. Okay, so that we can say it as a future goods. And the next we can say the last type, the third type is contingent goods. Okay, so contingent goods is nothing but it is a hypothetical situation. We are ordering a future goods. For example, we have ordered the we have the sale agreement for future goods. If we utilized that catering services after the 3 months, means that we can say it as a the sale executed. That is situation one for contingent. Situation two, if suppose the marriage is cancelled, we can't able to utilize that catering service. So situation two is the we didn't receive the, we didn't enter into that sale agreement. So that time we can say that is as a no sale. So contingent is the situation one and situation two. Situation one is if we buy the product in future, that is sale executed. If we are not buy the product in future, that is a no sale. Okay, so this is the hypothetical condition for the contingent goods. Okay, so these are the three types of goods. I'm just recalling you what we have saw now, means goods, what is goods, and what are the types of goods we have saw. One is existing goods, another one is future goods, and the last one is contingent goods. Under the existing goods, we have learnt about the ascertain, unascertain, and as well as the specific goods. Okay, so these are the types of goods. Okay, thank you.